Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and welcome back to another video on Next.js. This video is going to be a bit different. Yes, you can say we are going to build a beginner level project using Tailwind CSS and Next.js. We are going to build a calculator. If you are a beginner, then this project will help you to explore Next.js, JavaScript and Tailwind CSS at the beginner level. If you face any issues, then comment below or DM me on my social media handles. The links are down below in the description. So without wasting more time, let's get started. I started a Next.js app and these are my default settings for this project. Next, I opened the app in Visual Studio Code, but before writing any code, let's run this project using the command npm run dev. Okay, this is the default rendering of the Next.js app. Now if you go to the paste.js file, which is inside the app directory, you will find the default code of Next.js. This is the code of what we saw just now in the browser, but we are going to delete this default code. First, we will add a header with a h1 tag. Next, inside the global.css file, change the dark theme to light. In this project, I am going to use the useState hook. The useState hook in React is used to store variables that are part of an application's state. The Next.js page is by default set to the server side, and this page is going to render to the client side. So we have to add useClient at the top of our code. Here we are using something called state in a React component. Think of state as a way to keep track of important information within our app. Here we have two pieces of state, result and expression. Result will store the result of our calculations and it starts as an empty string. Expression is where we will store the mathematical expression we want to evaluate and it also starts as an empty string. This is where the real magic happens. When you click on a button in the calculator, this function gets called. Let's break it down. If you click the equal button, we try to evaluate the expression using eval expression. This means we calculate the result of the math expression you have typed in. If everything goes smoothly, we display the result using setResult. But if there is an error, like dividing by 0, we show error. If you click see, it clears everything, both the result and the expression. For all other buttons, numbers and operators, we add them to the expression. For example, if you click 7, it adds 7 to the end of the expression. This is an array that holds the labels for all the buttons of our calculator. They are arranged in a grid to make it easy to input numbers and operators. Here we are setting up the structure of our calculator. We have a main container with some styling, including a title, calculator, and a white background box for the calculator itself. These lines create an input field for displaying the expression or what the user is typing. It has some styling like a bottom border, making it easy for users to see what they are entering. Here is another input field, but this time it's for displaying the result of our calculations. It is slightly larger and bolder to make the result stand out. Now here is the fun part, the buttons. We have created a grid with 4 columns and a bit of spacing between the buttons. We are using the map function to generate buttons based on the values in the buttons array. Now check your project. You will see that our calculated applications work fine. But there is a problem here. Let's suppose you multiply 7 by 8, the result is 56. Then you add 4, the result is now 60. When you divide 60 by 3, the result should be 20, right? But here the calculator shows 57.333. You have this issue, right? So let's fix this. We update both the result and expression's state with the calculated result. This change ensures that the result is displayed in the input field, and if the user wants to perform further calculations, they can use the result as part of their expressions. And now all set. Now test your calculator. Okay, that's it. If you are starting things out, then I recommend you to play with the UI. Don't forget to share it with me. You can comment below or DM me on my social media handles, whatever you prefer. The links are down below in the description. Thanks for watching and see you in the next Nextjs video.